WGN Investigates has the story of a coronavirus cancellation controversy.
Investigative reporter Ben Bradley got involved and got results. He's here now. Ben?
Joe and Micah, months before COVID-19 became a household term, a blood and marrow transplant support group booked its annual conference at an East Coast hotel. As the virus spread, so did their concern and eventually their frustration with a global hotel chain and its response.
Quite literally, our folks are the poster child for the kind of person that should not be going to a large event.
North Shore resident Susan Stewart runs the Blood and Marrow Transplant Information Network. It's a nonprofit that helps transplant patients make critical decisions before and after their procedures. As awareness about the COVID-19 virus spread, they tried to cancel their 350-person conference booked for late April at the Hilton at Boston's Logan Airport.
There is no way that we could ethically put people in a position of being in a room where they might be exposed to the coronavirus, because for them, it could be lethal.
On March 9th, the group told the Hilton they wanted to cancel. The hotel's response? Sorry, but the contract says you only get a full refund if holding the conference is impossible. In an email, the senior sales manager wrote, "It is not illegal or impossible for the hotel to hold the event. As an aside, nor is there anything preventing you from holding the event." The hotel said it would keep the $5,000 deposit, and the nonprofit owed them $56,421 plus tax. 25% of that, though, could be used for a future booking.
Stunned.
Last week, WGN Investigates got involved. A Hilton spokesperson said the email was a negotiation of cancellation of fees.
I think they're a little tone deaf.
Today, a large Chicago law firm sent the hotel this scolding letter, and Boston's mayor has banned large group gatherings. So Hilton has relented and offered a full refund. For Sue Stewart and other transplant recipients, the uncertainty caused by COVID-19 will last even longer than it does for the general public.
For our population, there is really no way for us to be able to predict when it will be a safe time to hold this symposium again.
Tonight, Stewart tells me she is pleased that Hilton reversed its decision and no longer suggesting they put vulnerable people at risk simply because of a contract for meeting space. And she says she will work with them again when it's safe to host an event for bone marrow and stem cell transplant survivors.
Surprised she wants to go back to them after that.
I think she's a forgiving lady, but
she
Hilton eventually did the right thing.
All right. Thanks, Ben.
Thanks, Ben.